that the Lord of all the earth would care.
Tunaweza kukaa na nataka kuwasalimu na salamu za upendo wa Bwana wetu Yesu asifiwe. Brothers and sisters, you can sit. And wherever you are at home, just follow me. I will just give the passage that I will not be reading today, as I say, it is about the fourth Black Sunday. And why do I call it Black Sunday? Because it is not an issue thing during the sad times or sad days to stay at home and our churches to stay without the flock and also without tethering the flock that we normally comes here together for the service. So, brethren, wherever you are, I greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and Savior. This is the fourth Black Sunday in a row since the lockdown of the churches. May I take this chance to inform you that this is not normal or not ordinary, but we are supposed to pray hard and keep watch. Inspired to talk about the Passover. I ask you, what do you understand by the word Passover? The reading text is from Exodus chapter 12, verse 1 to 17, as it was read in Kiswahili. And I want to highlight some things. In summary, first of all, is about being obedient and to observe the rule and also the day that God has set in order to create some time to be with Him and to learn to Him. Also, keeping the day of the Lord and also giving ourselves as perfect sacrifice because all what happened, it was because of us. The Passover. Just change the symbols of the New Testament, Passover, to be bread and wine. As I always say, when we took the Holy Communion, we repeat the word of Jesus that said, do this always in remembrance of me. The more we partake the Holy Communion, the more we continue fulfilling what Jesus, the requirement of Jesus. I will not read the text because you are going to read for yourself once more. But I want to take you through five lessons, great lessons that are related to of the Passover that are related to just ultimate sacrifice. One, during the Passover, as we have read, the children of Israel were required to bring something or to give something to the Lord that was a lamb without blemish. First, the Israelites has to choose a lamb without blemish, meaning without spot, undefiled, and perfect, as we read Exodus chapter 12, verse 5. This lamb represented the future sacrifice of Christ, who was perfect without spot or blemish, particularly in the spiritual sense. Thus, he was perfect sacrifice for mankind's sin. This is made clear in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 18 to 19. Knowing that you are not redeemed with corruptible things like silver or gold from your aimless conduct received by tradition from your fathers, but with the precious blood of Christ as the lamb without blemish or without spot. The male lamb also had to be in his first year. This is the lamb's prime time of life. We see that Christ himself died at the age of 33, and we normally say also during this age it is the prime age. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Huu ni wakati ambao ukishafikisha miaka 20 mpaka prime age ni wakati ule ambao uko na nguvu na unafanya mambo ya kuinua jamii na unatumika katika mambo tofauti tofauti. Hii ndio inaitwa prime age. Na tiposa tunaona ya kwamba Yesu pia naye alikufa katika prime age, wakati ule alipokuwa anahitajika zaidi. Na tunaona ni kwa sababu he was innocent, sacrifice given at a time when human life is at its best. So, let me ask you, what kind of sacrifice do we often offer to our Lord? What kind of sacrifice have we offered ourselves to the service of the Lord? How do we deal when we come in giving, when we come in sacrifice, when we come in doing normal sacrifice, even enough time to be with our Lord? Also, the second point I want to share with you, that we normally derive from this Passover, it is the protection of God. What happened? Second, Israel had to eat the lamb without within their homes. With the blood applied to the doorways, Exodus 12, chapter 7, 13. In their homes, they were protected from the 10th plague, death of the firstborn. We see when they were told that during that night, do not come out and take supper within your home. And also, slaughter a lamb without a blemish and smear the blood. You are doorpost with that blood. And during that time, we see the angel of the Lord coming and slaying all the firstborns of Egyptians. And he was just skipping the houses of Israel, not because of any other thing, but because of the signs of the blood that was smeared in their doorpost. I repeat and tell you, whatever that we are going through, we are supposed to ask the blood of Christ, salvation, to be in us. Let us ask God to smear us with salvation so that even the age of destruction, the age of death will come, will not get us, will not strike us. Praise be to God. Passover, it is just the way the angel passed over the doors of the Israelites. Hallelujah. Even that, the same thing, when we are saved, when we are in Christ, the angel of the Lord will come and pass over us. Hallelujah. And we will destroy all those who will not conform. Na wale ambao hawatakuwa wamekubali injili na kutakaswa na damu ya mwana kondoo. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. So likewise, within the house of God, his temple and his church, which includes all who have the Holy Spirit, will be protected from the second death. If we continue in the faith and being led by the Holy Spirit, then Christ's sacrifice will enable us to receive the gift of everlasting life. This is the message of hope. When I ask you, Pastor, even this in this time where we are going through this hard period of corona pandemic, when we are in Jesus Christ, let us know that the Holy Spirit is with us and he will continue protecting us. Because Jesus promised that I am not going to leave you alone, but I will send the Holy Spirit who will be always with you during the time that you will live in this world until I come and take the church back to where it belongs. Hallelujah. At that point, we learn from the Passover is just give all. That they could eat the lamb only after it was roasted by fire, accompanied by unleavened bread and bitter herbs. When we read Exodus 12, verse 8. The roasting by fire symbolized Christ giving all for himself for man. It was eaten with unleavened bread because Christ was perfect and sinless. Thus, the bread had to be unleavened symbolically without sin. Hallelujah. We see when we take the bread we normally take, it is unleavened. It means that it is the bread without yeast. Haijao geswa ile dawa kufulisha. Na ilikuwa ni kuonyesha ya kwamba Yesu yeye mwenyewe alikuwa perfect. Hakuwa anastahili kuongezwa kitu kingine ili akaweze kukamilika. Na diposa hata nao wakaambiwa ya kwamba mkaweze kutumia kula hiyo nyama na mikate ambayo isiyo kiwa chachu. Maana Yesu alimaliza yote. The bitter herbs reminded Israel how they suffered in slavery in Egypt. Bitter kitu ambayo ni kichachu. Ilikuwa inadhihirisha ya kwamba mateso yale ambao waliokuwa, machungu yale ambao waliokuwa wanapitia na wanasikia wakiwa kule nchi ya Misri. And their bondage was indeed bitter, but it is also pointed to the bondage of sin which they were living and which came out of and are to stay out of. Even the body of sin, we need to feel that sin is a bitter thing in our lives, and we are supposed to come out of sin. We are supposed to come out of that state of sin. We are supposed to come out of that sinful nature. Our bodies need to be clothed with different garments that will cover us and will make us to be separate from the sinful bodies. So we need to come out of that sinful nature. That is why maybe we are passing through these bitter times. God wants to remind us we have sinned and he wants us to come out of that sinful nature. And also, we see even nowadays, people are eating raw meat. People are eating, drinking raw blood. People are doing funny things that are abominable. The children of God, the separated children of God, were asked not to eat. They were supposed to eat roast. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. It is against the Lord. It is against the will of God and the wish of God to eat raw meat, of which watu siku hizi hata hawajali. Wanakula tu nyama. Hajui kama imepikwa ikaiva ama haikuiva. Bora tu wakule. They are also eating abominable animals that the Bible says do not eat this. Brothers and sisters, we are being set apart by the blood of Christ because Christ has redeemed us. We are supposed to be careful even with what eating abominable things. If we want to live the life that will always please in God. The fourth lesson I want to share with you that we learn from the Passover, Christ truly died for all. Roasting with the fire pertains the whole lamb. Exodus chapter 12, verse 9. This pictures the total and complete sacrifice of Christ. just gave his life blood and was then resurrected to be our Savior in order for us to have the gift of eternal life. That is why Christ is different from all other sacrifices that were being offered, because animals were being killed at the birth and nothing, and that was more. Christ was killed, sacrificed, buried, but in that day he rose again, he conquered death. Means that also we have been died, we have to die with him, and also we have to conquer death and be in heaven with our God. We see the lamb was to be completely consumed. Any uneaten part was totally burnt with the fire. Exodus chapter 12, verse 10. No part of the lamb could thus be subject to decay or corruption, just as Christ's body was not to be corrupted. When we read also Acts chapter 13, verse 6 to 7. For David, after he had served his own generation by the will of God, fell asleep, was buried with his fathers, and saw corruption. But he who God lays up saw no corruption. Praise be to God. So, if there's any other thing that was left, it was not supposed to be kept in the refrigerator. It was not supposed to be preserved. It was to be burnt in the hot completely. Kulikuwa hakuna kitu kilichokuwa kinatakikana kikaweza kulala. Kumbuka hata wakati ule ambao Mungu alipowapa wana Israeli mana, aliwaambia kwamba yale yote mana nitakapowapa mkaweza kuyala, na yatakayobaki musipeleke nyumbani. God also always test us our obedience. And what happened? Because of disobedience, because of not people trusting and believing God, wakawa anaona ya kwamba hii tusipopeleka tutupe, pengine kesho hatutapata. Wakipeleka akiamka asubuhi ilikuwa imejaa mabua. Let us not, brothers and sisters, let us not doubt our God. God will, has come to save us. Hallelujah. And God will intervene to us even in this time of corona. Let us not doubt God. Let us believe and trust in him. But there is call for us to obey. The fifth point I want to share with you, do not look back. What I ask of your son. Do not look back. If you are watching me or listening to me, where you are listening to me, I know during the family setup it is very difficult to stay a meter to your spouse or to your children, because you always pray with them. But tell them, do not look back. Finally, the Israelites had to be fully prepared to leave Egypt and honor what they had known. It was a matter of preparing them to live where they have lived for. Wengine walikuwa wamesaliwa pale, wamekaa pale, hawakuwa wanajua mahali pengine popote, na ndiposa wanaambiwa ya kwamba now you are going to leave this place, to go even the place that they do not know. And always, when people do relocate, sometimes people are always, their hearts are always heavy, because they are relocating to new places, to new people, to new places, new environment, living where you have been used. The same case, but they were warned. Passover is a matter of warning us not to look back. Hallelujah. Because God has delivered us from sin, let us not look back to the ways of sin. Let us not look back where we have come from. Let us not admire anything. I know the journey might be tough because there is element of getting tired, there is element of getting angry, there is element of complaining and other things. But the Passover always is telling us, do not look back. Hallelujah. Even this time we are going through difficulties, and we have not gone through difficulties. Maybe hard times are going to come when maybe there will be total lockdown. People will not going out of their doors. Total lockdown. Do not look back. Do not look back. Do not give up. Everything that will come, it is coming for our own good. God wants us to save. Hallelujah. Want us to save us, want us to save the next generation. They would now have to look to God and live by his laws and not look back to Egypt. For us, the meaning is clear. Come out of this world and never look back. When we read in 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 17, and Luke chapter 17, 28, and to that 3, you see, we are supposed to know that we are not of this world. Hallelujah. So do not fear corona. Do not fear corona. Because corona will not even approach the gate of heaven. So let us have faith. God is always with us. Christ gave his life blood and was then resurrected to be our Savior in order for us to be have that gift of eternal life. When we read Romans chapter 5, verse 6 to 10. As Passover, we need to review the mirror lessons to remember what Christ sacrificed for us to become part of God's family. I assure you, because of accepting Christ in our Savior, the age of death, when we come back, will pass us. Because now our hearts, our bodies have been smeared by salvation of Jesus Christ, and that is the only sign that the age of the Lord, the age of death, will look. And when we see the signs of salvation, of Lord's salvation in you, it will just pass you and you will be saved. Hallelujah. Then that is what will enable you to go and enter the high gate. Hallelujah. On the way to heaven. Paul, as he was speaking to us through Ephesians chapter 10, we are God's work, at work, Tell your neighbor that you are part of God's art. As for you, you are dead in your transgressions and sins. We were dead. When we had not received Jesus Christ, we were dead. We were termed as dead. But when we received Christ Jesus Christ, we were revived. We were listened from the state of sin, not to the state of life, from the state of being condemned to the state of being accepted and getting favor before the Lord. All of us, we are seriously off track, but the great news is that God has intervened for us, and the coming of ages will reveal everything that God has in mind for us. We are now in Jesus. What we have now in Jesus and what we will have all is a gift. Our life response is deep gratitude and then doing the good work he made us to do. When this happens, our lives become the work of the art he always intended them to be. Whenever we do good, whenever we do the will of God, then we completely become and express that we are whatever God intended to do for us to do, we are doing it, and also we are fulfilling it here on earth, and also that will enable us also to have a portion in the heaven. Now, Paul was also writing to us and telling us, surely, whatever we are going through, it is like Paul was aware. You have heard about the administration of God's grace that was given to him. That in the mystery made known to me by the revelation, as I have already written briefly in reading this, then you will be able to understand my insight into the ministry of Christ, which was not made known to people. The mystery is that the gospel, the Gentiles are heirs together with Israel, members together, we are one body, and shares together in the promise of Jesus Christ. We are one body, one Jesus is your son. And that is why Christ died for all. See, not only Israelites, Christ died for all, for the whole humankind, so that we may become heirs of Jesus Christ. In conclusion, as I conclude, in the midst of satanity, uncertainty and fear, death, we can trust that God is sovereign over our lives. All the days ordained for us were written in your book before one of them came to be. If we read Psalm 139, verse 16, and if we read Matthew 6, verse 27, it is asking a question, can anyone of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your life? Whatever kind of worries, let us put all our worries to God. Let us not worry about Corona. Let us not please Corona more than we please God. Let us know that we have a great God who is more great than Corona. Hallelujah. Why worry? Let us not spend a lot of time worrying, because even our worry cannot extend anything in our lives. Hallelujah. Even in this midst of uncertainty, fear, we are always fearing death. But to us, we are different. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Bwana atusaidie. Because we are saved by the grace of God. Hallelujah. And the grace of God will always be sufficient to us. Let us always focus to Him. Let us always do what is expected of us, and God will continue blessing us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, thank you, King of God, because of this opportunity that you have given me to stand before this pulpit of your King of God, this altar, to speak to your people wherever they are listening to me. I pray that you will continue, O dear Lord, helping us to understand the meaning of the Passover and absorb these 5 points that I have shared with your people, O dear King of God, so that we may be able to continue doing what is good, and to know that you have called us, and now we are unblemished because of the salvation and the blood of Jesus Christ that was shed for us in the cross. Thank you, Lord, thank you, Jesus. May you grant us your salvation. May you save our lives. May you save everything that that has been affected by the pandemic. And may you restore everything that we need to have for the sake of your glory. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Praise be to God. Wherever you are, I want to appreciate. First of all, I want to thank all of you who are always keen and listening and also leading the messages and the devotions. You can also continue supporting, and I want to appreciate to those who continue supporting the ministry through M-Pesa Pay Bill number 857874. Using the same M-Pesa, and you want to direct to deposit direct to the church account or the KCB account, you just key in 522-522, the pay bill, and the account number is 1178173232. For NBK, 625625 is the pay bill. Account number is 010-380-918-25700. And CDN Bank is, the pay bill number is 111-999. Account number is 010-350-2000-4181. And for pay bill number that has been given, to support through the county, but also even we have our neighbors, we have our neighbors who are immigrating in India. I appeal for any kind of donations to be brought into the church through respective leaders of our fellowship. Kindly, whatever you feel to give to support the needy, so that we may see how we are going to help them. Kindly see your leader, and if it is a kind of money sent through them, then forward to our office. Then we will sit and do the necessary. If it is a form of kind, you can still, if you still you are able to bring it to the church, I have said the office is open, you will be assisted, bring that that kind of offering. And if you feel that the church is far, still, you can take that tithe to your zonal leader, and the zonal leader will organize, will call, we shall organize for transport. Let us support for the needy. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Hata wakati mfalme Ishemi tunaendelea kulishukuru na kulitukuza jina lako. Naombea watu wote mfalme Ishemi dere pahali popote walipo. Naomba kwa ajili ya afya yao mfalme Ishemi dere na akaweze kuwa na amani. Naomba Baba adumu akaweze kuwa na nguvu. Naomba Baba adumu akaweze kuwa na upendo. Naomba Baba adumu akaweze kuwa na uvumilivu. Naomba Baba adumu kawezesha Baba adumu kushida hata mambo yale yote Baba adumu tunayapitia. Tunahitaji neema yako na baraka zako Baba adumu. Hata wakati tunapopitia katika hiki kipindi hiki, tusaidie Baba adumu tukaanze kuwa mstari wa mbele, tusaidiane na kuzingatia yale sheria Baba adumu zimewekwa, ili Baba adumu tukaanze kupunguza na kuangamiza huu ugonjwa wa korona kabisa. Tuomba neema na baraka zako Baba adumu, na fadhili zako pia Baba adumu ziendelee kwa ya sasa. Amani yako Baba inayopita fahamu za watu wote izidi kuwa pamoja nasi na kutulinda katika hali ya kutuongoza katika hali ya kutujua na kututenga. Na baraka yako Mungu Baba mwenye enzi, Mwana na Roho Mtakatifu iwe nasi sote sasa na hata milele. Bwana awabariki sana. God bless you. God bless you.